Hi everyone, welcome to the product management section of Etsy Marketplace Integration app by CedCommerce. Now, prior to managing your product, you must have carried out this profiling action. And if you haven't, certainly you won't be able to see your products in the grid. Okay, so I had already a profile created in my account. Now, for those who haven't created a profile, they won't be able to see their products in the grid. So let's show you how to go about profiling. Click here to add new profile. Now in the profiling section, you have to first fill in a profile name. Then you have to select, either you can go with automated profiling or manual profiling. In all those profiling sections, you will have to select your type, vendor and other details. Then in the mapping section, you can select marketplace category for your product. You can map your attributes. You have additional as well as required attributes, but remember that mapping both the attributes is very, very important. Now, in the shipping template section, you can select the existing template or create a new one. Same goes with the inventory management template. What do I mean by this? This means again you can select an existing one or create a new one. Then in the price management section also, you can select an existing one or create a new pricing template. After completing all the shown processes, you need to click on save to have your profile created. Now after profiling, going in the product section will make you see your products. Here I can see my products. So after you see your products, you can perform multiple actions on your product. Before going on or jumping onto actions, let me tell you that you can expand your product. On expanding your product, you will be able to see the variant details and other details about your product, such as inventory, price, status, weight, etc. You also have the option of editing your product. Now you can edit general information about your product, such as title, description, vendor, tags, etc. Then in Etsy attributes, you have required as well as additional attributes as selected during the time of profiling. So you can go about editing those as well. In case of variants, you can see image, you can see your price and inventory, and we'll cover more about variants in the later part of the video, so keep watching. In the images section, this particular product has only one image, but you can select up to 10 images, and the images should be 1500 pixels wide, and the height of the image can vary. Let's show you one product which has multiple images. Now as you can see, this particular cap has multiple images. You can set any image as your primary image. Primary images are the images that your buyer will first see. So any image can be selected as your primary image, but by default the first image is selected as a primary image. So you need to make sure that the image you want to be shown to your buyers first should be selected as the primary image. Now after these editing of the product, you can save the edited details from here. Now moving on to actions. First of all, you need to sync every detail that your product has on Shopify to the app. For that, we have this sync from Shopify action. Clicking on this will show this particular page. From here, you can select the fields you want that should be synced from Shopify. Suppose I have changed title of a product on Shopify and I want every time the updation takes place, the title of the products or anything is synced. So I'll click all the fields that I want to be synced from Shopify for a particular product from here, and then I can click on update. Now after syncing all the details from Shopify, I'm good to go to the other relevant actions. Now, if you are already an existing Etsy seller, you can click on this sync with Etsy. Why is this action very important? This action is very important because it will bring the details of all your existing Etsy products to the app. So you will have all your products listed at one place, that is on our app, and then you can manage accordingly. Now clicking on sync from Etsy will show you all the relevant details about your product, such as listing ID, title from Shopify. This you will not be shown. This is you can choose for your product, status and action. Now what is the relevance of this particular section? From here you can map titles for your products. For example, I'm having this product. I can choose corresponding Shopify category for this product from here. This will help me in syncing my Etsy products with Shopify, which will make my product management much easier. Now, back to other actions. I have already told you about sync from Shopify. After that, you have to click on publish. Now, why am I showing you this? See, after syncing all the information from Shopify, you can publish your products. This will lead to listing all your products on the app on the marketplace, and you want that. Now we have missed. See, if you will not set up your currency, your products will not be published. So why setting up currency is very important? Setting up currency is very important because you might have set your products on Shopify in a different currency and Etsy doesn't accept every currency. So you need to make sure that you have your products in USD. This brings us to a very important section, that is the setting section. In the product management section of the setting section, from here you can set the currency which we were talking about. Now in the Etsy update section, from here you can choose the options that you want to manage from our app. Suppose, see, by default these options are already selected, but see, if I disable this action, this means that I do not want to manage my Etsy product from the app. So now after disabling this, I can manage my Etsy products from Etsy itself. So this is for you to choose what all things you want to manage from the app and what all things you want to manage directly. Now this auto delete option will help you to delete your active products from Etsy when product is deleted from Shopify, unpublished from Shopify, or goes out of stock. Now this auto syncing action has been provided to automatically sync your details from Shopify. What happens, whichever field you will select will automatically be updated from the app whenever changes are made on Shopify. So next is product creation. Product creation is helpful for creating syncing the products to the app whenever a new product is created on Shopify. You can create products on the basis of type, vendor and everything. Okay, now going back to our grid. We told you can publish your products right now. After that, you can sync your price and inventory with Etsy. That means if you update price and inventory for a product and perform this particular action, the same will be reflected on the marketplace. Same goes with image. Then you have multiple options to change the product status on Etsy. We had already performed publish action, so all your products are on Etsy. From here you can change the status of those existing products. If I click active to remove one of my products, see, apps, I had selected this product and then I chose active to remove. This means that this will lead to removing this product which was active. One thing which is very important about this particular action is that whenever you will relist an existing product which was active but you removed. You have to remember that the marketplace, that is Etsy, is going to charge you $0.20 per listing. So be very wise while performing this action and other actions as well. Now, if you want your product details in the form of CSV, you can export it from here. You can edit the details of your products in a bulk in that CSV, converting them in editable form, and then you can import the CSV from here. Okay, and also in exporting CSV, you have options that whether what details you want in your CSV. If I click price, if I click description, my CSV will be containing these things. I think I'm done with most of the actions, and yes, I told that we are going to cover a particular section so that you are able to know how to manage your variants well. So let's get to that. Okay, so this product is having variants. See, about variants, we have provided attribute mapping section. This particular product has variants only in color. So had it have variants in size also, we would have provided a section for attribute mapping for size. Now you can map your attributes from here. You can map your attributes with the Etsy attribute. You can edit the price inventory of the variants, and this ignore button is very important. See, Etsy allows only 70 variants to be uploaded, and that too on the basis of size, color and material combinations in matrix format. So you have limitations for uploading variants. So whichever variant you feel that is not going to upgrade your business so much for that particular time, you can ignore that variant, and then that variant will not be uploaded on Etsy marketplace. So yes, we have told you how to edit your product details, how to bring your details from Shopify, and how to publish your products on Etsy. After having published your products, how to go about changing the status of the products and everything. So we really hope that after watching the video, you are able to manage your products well on Etsy. Well, in case of any inconvenience, you can contact us anytime. And yes, so have a great business, have a great time selling on Etsy. Thank you.